Hello and welcome to the Reclaiming channel. Today I would like to show you how to recover data from devices on which ZFS file system is used. You can usually find ZFS file system in storage devices, which are made on the basis of FreeNAS environment. Unlike ordinary file systems, ZFS is a so-called hybrid of a file system and a logical volume manager, allowing you to combine different storage devices, whether it's a hard drive or a disk image file, into a single storage space, a so-called ZFS pool, with various levels of redundancy. There are different types of ZFS pools.
Single disk, in which redundancy isn't used. Tri-pool, it's just like RAID 0, in which data blocks are distributed over the member disks. Also, there is no redundancy. Mirror pool, is like RAID 1, in which metadata and user data are stored in two copies. RAID Z1 pool is similar to a RAID 5, where a parity function is calculated over the data blocks. However, there are significant differences between RAID Z and RAID 5. Block size can vary in the same pool from a sector to several kilobytes. The number of blocks in a row is also not a constant, and depends on the number of data blocks involved in a particular single write operation. RAID Z2 pool is like a RAID 6, but has the same differences as a RAID Z1 to a RAID 5.
So to recover the data from a slightly damaged ZFS volume, you need to prepare the Windows PC for the recovery.
It's important to take into account the amount of RAM. 8 GB minimum is required for ZFS recovery, but the bigger the better. Also, you need to provide stable internet connection.
Decide how you will connect the drives to the PC. It's better to connect drives directly to the motherboard using SATA cable, but you can use the USB to SATA adapter as well. Also, prepare the drive that will be used to copy the recovered data. So connect SATA and power.
When the drives are connected, go to our site www.reclaim-pro.com and download the software. Run the software, click Proceed, enter the key and click Proceed. Mark ZFS under the target partition, types and click Proceed. If ZFS metadata isn't corrupted, you will see that ZFS is highlighted in black. Amber means that the ZFS volume has missing disks, but still can be reconstructed based on redundancy. Red means that the ZFS volume is not readable. Once ZFS volume is virtually reassembled, select it and click Start Scan. Then you are offered to preset ZFS file system. Click OK. Check the recovery result in the preview. Files are shown good. Then, if you have a persistent license key, you can start to copy the data. The last step is to check that the files are opened correctly. Our ZFS recovery is done.
Reclaiming team was with you. See you soon.